Yes.
My name is. My name is Ochaya Inalego, and I came to ask a question about the chaplet. We the Catholics use the chaplet. Is the chap?
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
Is the road? The road is, I think, good.
Hey. Yes, go ahead. Just speak. It is talking. You say, what do they use the chaplet to do? Put it near your mouth.
They use it to pray.
To pray to who?
To Mary. I want to ask whether is it good.
To pray to Mary and who?
Only Mary.
Only Mary.
And I want to ask whether is it good.
It's okay. Okay, they will be using it and be counting. Is that?
Yes.
They count how many? How many of them constitute a prayer?
It's 59.
59. By the time you count 59, Mary has heard.
I don't know how to ask.
Okay, I like your question. I am happy with your question because the way you ask this question, you make me to know that you sincerely love God. You want to know the truth and you want to serve God. Now, you don't pray to Mary because Mary is not God. All the saints that are in heaven, including Mary, they don't hear what goes on earth. This thing we're doing here, only God hears us, not angels, except the limited angels that are here for duty. The other angels who are in Abuja, who are in Lagos, who are in various places, they don't hear what we're doing here now. The person who can hear what is going on universal, all over the world, is God alone. If we now say Mary hears prayers in heaven today, is then we have said Mary is like God. Because it means prayers in America, Mary will hear. Prayers in Nigeria, Mary will hear. Prayers in London, Mary will hear. Prayers in the jungle, in other places, Mary will hear. It shows that Mary is God. And to also to say Mary is God is idolatry. You are making Mary God, and there's no God but one. So we have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit that make up one God. And only this one God has the power to hear prayers in a universal place. Whether you're in the depth of the sea, if you speak there, he will hear. If now the Catholics will say Mary is hearing prayers in heaven where she is now, they are serving idols, because they want to join Mary to the Trinity to become Fonity. It means there are four persons in one God: the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and Mary. Is it like that? If Mary is not God, is not one of the gods, why are they now saying Mary is hearing prayers in heaven? Apostle Paul, Mary is not holier than Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul in heaven doesn't know what is going on here. He's not hearing us. Peter doesn't hear what is going on, because the saints in heaven are not gods. They cannot hear what is going on earth. If you begin to say in the Peter, oh, hey, Peter, pray for me. Peter is not even hearing you, because God, except God gives opportunity for a privileged information on earth to be told them in heaven, they don't hear what is going on earth. So it means, therefore, that those who are praying to the saints, praying to Mary, praying to whichever saint, they are wasting their time, because such prayers don't go to God. In fact, they are serving idols, because they have exalted somebody in the position of God, and that is idolatry.
Some people say that if you are a queen, and they like, would they honor you? And I say that it's not right that they should stop it. That Mary is not hearing what they are saying on earth. And my third question is that, are perfumes good?
No, say what you were saying before. Some people say that what?
Some people say that if you are a mother of a prince.
Mother of twins.
Of a prince.
Okay, of a prince, yes.
That would they honor you?
That God will favor you.
That would they honor you?
Praise the Lord. She is saying that people say that if you're a mother of a priest, that won't people honor you?
Okay, yes. Yeah, go ahead.
That's my question.
So that's why Mary should be honored.
That's what some people are saying.
According to them, since Mary is the mother of Jesus, a great person, won't she be honored?
That's what they're saying.
Yes. If Mary should be honored, is she the first person that is honorable, that is connected to God in an honorable way? Abraham was the father of faith, the one that God chose. Are Catholics honoring him as they honoring Mary? What about Sarah, which is called the mother of faith, who began the Christian faith generally? Is she honored as they honor Mary? What about King David? And that is the father of Jesus on this earth. Is David honored? Do they pray to David as they're praying to Mary? Jesus called himself Son of David. People call him Son of David. David is a king whose kingship was established over Israel forever. Are people honoring him like that?
No.
It's because that of Mary, Satan came in and confused human beings, to destroy them so that none of them should go to heaven, so that God can be jealous over them with godly jealousy, because they are turning a human object that he made into a god like him, giving honor to him. You know, do you know that the honor they gave to Mary is more than to Jesus Christ himself? Now, in Sao Tome, there is a feast there, a particular feast, a ceremony. It is a yearly one, during which the people who hold the image of Jesus will go and bow before the people who hold the image of Mary. That Jesus is pleading with Mary to forgive him for calling him woman. Because on the cross, Jesus said, "Woman, behold thy son." He said, how could Jesus be addressing Mary, woman? How could Jesus? Jesus needed to apologize for that. So the people were divided into two camps. One holding the image of Mary, another holding the image of Jesus. And those who are holding the image of Jesus will come and kneel down before those holding the image of Mary to say, sorry for calling you woman. It has gone far. Catholics in Sao Tome, it has gone very far. So these things are satanic. What is happening in the Catholic Church is nothing but the devil. Righteousness is not there. Truth is not there. Heaven does not belong to them, because they are in darkness of sin and iniquity, darkness of error. So people need to pray for those in Catholic Church, in Jesus' name. So those chaplains, chaplets, don't use them. They don't mean anything. They are items of idolatry. You know, don't Muslims use chaplets too? They are praying to somebody who will not hear, and you too are praying to somebody who will not hear. You are the same. So throw those things away.
I want to ask another question.
Yes.
Her perfume's good.
Okay. What time do you come? Because I spoke about perfume here. You came late too?
Oh, this is my first time of coming.
But I think I spoke about it today. Okay, you didn't come early in the morning. Okay, for your sake. You know, we appreciate you. We want you to go to heaven. So I will say it again. Is that clear? Now, we say, God created everything with natural perfume, natural scent. The orange tree, the orange fruit has its own scent. The leaves, their own scent. The pineapple have its own scent. Various things, even animals. Each animal varies in its own smell, scent, as God gave them natural perfume. So the human being too has his own natural perfume. So to add artificial perfume on yourself is iniquity, is evil, is sin. It's like you want to add additional thing to another perfume on orange, or the natural one the orange has. You want to add, so this additional thing you're adding to yourself is evil. Although you say it gives you sweet smell, look at it in the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 3. Isaiah chapter 3. Let us read verse 24. And it shall come to pass that instead of sweet smell, there shall be sting. And instead of a girdle, a rent. And instead of a well-set hair, baldness. And instead of a stomacher, a guiding of sackcloth. And burning instead of beauty. So this perfume that you see people use, they are still items of attraction and beauty. To look fine, to smell good, you appear fine, according to this other items of beauty, which is of evil and sin. So the Bible says they put this thing upon them for a sweet smell, but the judgment of God will come upon them. They shall send for stinking odor. That's what the Bible is telling us. So avoid those things. Let's write. Make me holy. Make me holy. Make me holy, oh Lord. In the morning, in the night, any time you may come. Holy.
Make me holy,